Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I know I am uploading after a very long time. I was busy with my exams, I had a lot of other work to do, so I'm sorry for posting this video after a long time. So basically I was just doing the maintenance of my 2 feet aquarium, and many of the comments of my viewers came to my mind, and a lot of them have this thought, like, why does my tank and how does my tank look so clean and healthy, and why are the plants so growing well even though I'm not using any high-tech products like aqua soil or any aquarium planted aquarium lights and all that stuff. So how can it be, how does my tank look so clean and healthy while I claim it to be without any maintenance for 5 weeks? So this tank right now that you see has been going on for 5 weeks without any maintenance, and I tell you, without any water change at all. So am I lying? Of course not. So there is any secret about it? Well, there's no secret about it, but there are some things which, if you follow, you will also be able to have a tank that you won't need to do maintenance for months. And I've been following these things, I learned them from someone else, and I'm telling you this so you can also follow this and have a tank like this. So here are the 6 things that I think personally would help you to have a no maintenance or a low maintenance tank. So the first one is to choose the right sized tank. What does this mean? It means your tank should be of the appropriate size, considering the amount of plants you are going to put in, considering the amount of fish and the size of fish that you are going to put in. So before taking the decision to buy a tank, think about what fish you are going to put in, what kind of aquascape you are going to make, and then choose the right size of the tank. Number 2, plant in abundance. By this I mean plant heavily. Literally heavily. It should look like a literal jungle. Now, why? Why is the main question. So when you plant heavily, there are a lot of plants that will utilize your fish waste, your ammonia production in the water, your bioload in the water will be balanced by the plants. Okay, so you don't have to do water changes again and again, or the water won't turn foul, or you don't even need a filter if you have a lot of plants. And while you're going to plant in abundance, keep in mind to keep a thick substrate layer. Okay, so there will be a different video. I will be making another video on substrate layer itself, explaining how you can achieve a good, healthy and nutritious substrate layer for your planted aquascape. But for now, keep in mind to have a thick substrate layer if you are going to plant in abundance. Number 3, choose hardy fish and try to keep minimum bioload. Now, hardy fish means strong, healthy fish that won't suffer in even worse conditions. Hardy fish, like, I personally would recommend guppies. Guppies are really hardy, even tetras are hardy. Keep in mind to choose hardy fish. Why? Because even if by mistake something happens that is not supposed to happen, your fish will not be under a lot of stress. Okay, so try to buy hardy fish. Another thing about buying fish is to keep a minimum bioload. Like if you're buying guppies, try to keep minimum 10, I would suggest. Eventually they will reproduce like crazy and you will have a ton load of guppies in your tank. But most of the babies will be eaten up by the parents themselves, so it will balance itself out. But try to keep the bioload to a minimum. Like in a 2 feet of tank, you can keep, I would say, 12 tetras, bottom feeder, an algae eater, shrimps, snails. Shrimps and snails can go on a larger number, but try to keep the fish as less as possible. Okay, now number 4 is not to overfeed. Now this is very important. A lot of fish keepers have this urge to feed their fish whenever they see the fish coming towards them when they get near to the tank. Bro, don't do this. Do not overfeed. When you are putting the fish food in the tank, you are just adding more and more bio load. The plants will be overwhelmed. There will be an ammonia spike. The fish will not eat all the food. They will just eat as much as necessary, and the leftover food will be rotting away in your tank, making the water foul. So do not overfeed. Number 5. Avoid doing more than 30% water changes in the initial weeks of setup. Now, doing water changes, I personally don't do water changes, so why am I suggesting you this? Basically, I do water changes during the initial stages of the tank, but when the tank reaches a particular time when it is self-sustainable, the water is not fouling, the ammonia levels will be lesser, and you eventually get that feeling that the tank does not need any water changes. The water will be crystal clear all the time. So try to keep water changes near 30 or between 30 to 50% in 1 week. Don't do daily water changes or twice a day. Once a week, 30 to 50% is enough. And number 6 and the last one is minimum interference. Now when I say this, understand that I am speaking based on my personal experience. The less you interfere with the ecosystem inside the tank, the more you give it the chance to survive and sustain itself. So please just don't put your hand inside the water for no reason at all. Let the nutrients in the tank get recycled, get absorbed by the plants, and then they will eventually convert the whole tank into an ecosystem where the fish is pooping, the plants are using up the poop, they are releasing oxygen, which is used up by the fish. The only thing you need to do is feed your fish once a day, just a pinch, depending on the number of fish and the size of fish you have, obviously, but that is all you need to do. Just feed your fish, everything will balance itself out. So these 6 points are essential if you want to have a tank like this. See you in another video. I would love to read your comments. That's it then. Bye. See you in the next video. Till then, take care.